To the president's chagrin, demonstrations continued. In 1965, protests targeted Selma, Alabama, the seat of Dallas County, where fewer than 1% of eligible blacks were registered to vote. And where bully boy segregationist Sheriff Jim Clark and his deputized citizens' posse rounded up civil rights activists using Gestapo tactics and cattle prods. SNCC's John Lewis was among more than 2,000 demonstrators jailed in the first months of 1965. The Reverend C.T. Vivian, an organizer for the Southern Christian Leadership Conference, led the Selma campaign.
We're willing to be beaten for democracy, and you misuse democracy in the street. You beat people bloody in order that they will not have the privilege to vote. You beat me in the side and then hide your blows.
But go on.
No, I don't need to leave. We have come to register to vote. And you must realize that this is a national issue. It's not a Selma issue. It's not an Alabama issue. This is a national issue. Whenever anyone does not have the right to vote, then every man is hurt. I don't need to leave. We have come to...
On the night of February 18th, state troopers savagely attacked Vivian and other demonstrators. In the chaos, a young man named Jimmy Lee Jackson was shot at point-blank range in what the local newspaper called a nightmare of state police stupidity.
He was murdered by the irresponsibility of every politician from governors on down who has fed his constituents the stale bread of hatred and the spoiled meat of racism.
The tragedy galvanized the Selma voting rights campaign. SCLC's James Bevel proposed a symbolic march from Selma to the Alabama state capitol in Montgomery, more than 50 miles away. On March 7, 1965, SNCC's John Lewis and the SCLC's Hosea Williams led a procession of more than 500 marchers over the Edmund Pettus Bridge. Alabama state troopers, clad in gas masks and riot gear, waited on the other side.
It'll be detrimental to your safety to continue this march, and I'm saying that this is an unlawful assembly. You are ordered to disperse, go home, or go to your church. This march will not continue.
News cameras immortalized a hellish scene of police brutality and chaos. Images of Bloody Sunday shocked the nation. Time magazine reported that rarely in human history has public opinion reacted so spontaneously and with such fury.